Hello, it's Robert from the Dr. Bubble channel on YouTube. How are you? Hope your day is going well. Now, this is my second tutorial discussing how to make these very nice curved pipes. Now, I know that you can do this in other ways on 3ds Max. One way is to make splines, and the other way is to loft. Now, imagine that there's other ways as well. But my preferred method is to use hinge from edge, as you can see here. Now, piping will make your spacecrafts, your oil refineries or factories much more complex. And of course, they are part of the actual complex itself. But for spacecraft, they can give some realism and some sort of you could say sensibility, in as much as if you have one sort of engine that we have here, you kind of expect to have some sort of fuel intake and outtake pipes in some part of the engine core. Now, it all depends, because obviously it's engineered differently, and we are using our imaginations after all. That said, it can give some credence if you build piping in the correct way and put it in the right place. Welcome back to the practical part of this tutorial. Now, I've just made some test pipes here, as you can see in the blue color. These have been made from hinge from edge. They took me around 5 to 10 minutes, and as I said before, it's very easy to make. So let's move on. There we go, just hide that selection. Zoom in on here and get a good angle. Press F4 to get the edge faces. Now, I've got two instances here, so anything I do to the master copy will translate across to these little fellas here. So I'm moving upwards, as you can see. Anything I do will affect these instances. So let's make some pipes. So I like to use another tool called the bevel tool. I like to use it in the freestyle manner because it gives me greater control on large objects. There we go. By all means, use the settings box there if you're not too familiar or not too confident to use the bevel tool in a freestyle way. Whatever works best for you, of course. Press T and press Z to zoom. Now press select and move here. Now you'll get this, the axis up, and what you want to do is to hold down shift and press on the Y and push it down, and make sure there's a gap between the newer geometry and the old geometry, so this is actually part of it. Anyway, you'll get this dialog box that pops up and clone to element, which you want to press, and this keeps both of these as one object as opposed to being detached. So press OK, go to vertex mode and press on these verts here, and they could be these verts or those verts, long as it produces a straight line, then press connect. This is the part where it's going to hinge from, so select the face again. Press hinge from edge. Now, a little caddy again always comes up in the latest versions of Max, and you have three options: angle, segments, and pick hinge. So we press that, and it's obviously highlighted by the blue outline. So press on the line we just made, and as you can see, the previous settings have been set at 180 degrees. The default setting is 30, but I want to use 90. So there you have it. So let's continue. You can see the nice nature of the curve, giving it a nice organic flavour. Let's do some more beveling. Now, I would like the curve to go from here to the left and curve round. So go to the F, go to front viewport. Again, press the select and move button and zoom in. Hold down shift and this time on the X. Hold down the X. And make sure there's a little gap there, otherwise you'll get some indifferent geometry. Again, press clone to element. This time we want the selection of verts to be on the vertical. Here, and press connect. Now, this next operation will probably produce indifferent results, but not to worry. As you can see, Max's way of going insane, but you can provide some more sanity by pressing the pick hinge again, and it goes highlighted, and press on the edge, and as you can see, it's obviously corrected itself. This time, 180 degrees, and again, you can see what it can do in terms of organic looking piping, which is very useful and very, you know, doesn't take much time. So we want to go upwards and produce a nice S shape. So if we go this time, hold down shift and press on the X and move up, clone to element again, select verts. It's very repetitive, so it gives you a good opportunity to get used to it. Again, it's producing different results, not the problem. Let's select here, and again, it's produced a nice abstract looking pipe, which obviously is not practical, but you can see what the actual tool does, and we can keep beveling to a heart's content. So there you go, there's an example, and as you can see, there's a very organic looking pipe. Now I'm going to move on to the next part to give some other you could say advice on the tool itself. So hello and welcome back to the third and final part of this tutorial discussing the Hinge from Edge tool. This time I've got a cube and I would like to obviously make an indentation on the inside. So again, select the face that you want and press the settings box and click to choose your edge, and to achieve this I'm gonna dial in 180 degree. Doesn't do an awful lot, sometimes this happens and it's not a problem. It's only because the segments are down to 1, so if you boost it up down to 10 and press delete, because the tool produces another face, and you'll have another face and delete that. At this point, because the very nature of the tool produces more vertexes, it's recommended to get rid of them. So press on vertex mode, press Control A to select those verts, and press weld, oops, just here. And as you can see, it's got rid of 6 additional verts that were just laying around doing nothing. So let's evict those verts by pressing tick. And there you go, you have like a quick alcove or indentation or a little room that you can store bits and pieces in. Of course, you can do anything you like. You can also, for example, maybe see, straighten these out. Go to inset and choose the extrude, so you extrude backwards, so you can see the applications it has. You can use it in variable creative ways, providing you do the welding as well, because that's most important. Also, you can use the tool manually, much like the bevel tool, but it can be less flexible, in as much as that let me just show you. I click on the edge, hold down the left mouse button, and you can move up and down. Now this may seem more flexible, but it's less precise, and you cannot adjust the segments. The segments are from the original settings that you may have used before, so make sure you adjust those if you want to do it manually, but I don't really recommend this. I recommend using the settings boxes and going from there. Oops, there we go. So there you have it. So this is the end of the tutorial, and thanks for watching. I have a call out for a Blender artist who produces some very fine futuristic spacecraft. He has a name, but I don't know what it is. The name on his YouTube channel is YGVB1. So hello to you, sir, and keep up the good work. That said, again, if you have any comments or any ideas, please feel free to post them underneath the video. So take care of yourself and goodbye.